Now, when Titleist launched drivers, they usually get quite excited about it, but I think with the new TS range of drivers, they're a little bit more excited than they normally are. And if you've been around on social media, you know there's a lot of buzz around these two drivers. So what is making them special? Well, the previous 917 driver, whilst it was very consistent and certainly one of the straighter drivers I think that was in the market, it probably lacked a little bit in speed. And Titleist are kind of the first to say that. So the TS stands for Titleist Speed Project. And they've brought out two models here. And the aim of this driver is really to get back to basics, to understand what makes a driver work, and then really design the driver from the ground up again. So there's two models again. There's a TS2 and a TS3, which is almost like the D2 and the D3 before, and they're really set up to be slightly different models. And I'm just going to explain the benefits of the two to see if you can understand the differences between the two, and then also compare it to the previous model as well. So first up, the TS2 is what they're calling their bomber driver, which is basically the less adjustable one, and it's got probably a slightly more drawn back head than the TS3, which would be like your D3 driver, which is allegedly for the slightly better player. It's got a slightly straighter face. There is actually less bulge and roll on this. It's half a degree less bulge and roll than they had on the previous drives. And a lot of brands have been playing around with the bulge and roll on the faces lately. Really why Titleist felt that they haven't had the need to do that is because the face is already quite forgiving as it is. They've increased the MOI by 12% on the previous model. And they've done that by really dropping the CG as low and as far back as possible. They've done this a couple of ways, and this applies to both models. They made the titanium crown a little bit thinner. They say it's 20%, but it's actually only 0.1 millimeter difference. It's now only 0.4 millimeters thick. But they say this is the thinnest titanium crown in the market. They've also changed the shape of the driver. The crown is a lot more of a sort of steeper rise at the front, and then it drops off more quickly. And again, this is an aerodynamic effect. It helps the air stay attached to the club a little bit longer. It's a bit like having you know, the speed steps, the turbulators, and all the stuff you see in other drivers. The same principle, but you can do it with just the shape of the driver. And I know that they tested all these different effects and figured that this one was the best for them. The only other difference with the TS3 is instead of the rear weight at the back of the sole, you've actually got the SuroFit CG weight, which fits like a tube into the back of the driver. Now, this is a little bit different to the one before. Rather, in the past, you had a neutral and a weight that was unbalanced, so you could be draw or fade. This is now just one single weight, and it very cleverly has a little magnet on one end, which you flip from one end to the other, and that is what creates the unbalancedness. And then depending which end you put in will create the fade or the draw. So if you put the heavy end towards the heel, that should create the draw, and if you put the heavy end towards the toe, then that should create the fade. So compared to the previous 917D driver, what you will notice is that both shapes are probably a little bit larger. I think the TS3 compared to the D3, which I've got here, even that still looks a little bit larger, it looks a little bit rounder, maybe a little bit squarer, I'd have to say, even though they're saying that this is their traditional shape. I think neither shape is particularly traditional. I think they're more modern in terms of being large and having that deeper head with a deep CG. The color of the head has gone back to the dark black head, which Titleist had before, and I have to say, I think that's a great change. I wasn't really a fan of the sort of light gray color before. I think it gives a much more stealthy look. And the graphic on the top of the club, again, has reverted to what it was in 915, with the pointy head pointing towards the target, rather than 917, where it was pointing the other way. So that's the main technical differences between the two products. Let's see how they perform. I'm going to start off here with the TS2 driver. And really down at the dress, you can see that this has that much straighter look. I actually don't mind it. I think it looks pretty good. It doesn't feel like it's not going to loft in at all, even though this is actually a 9.5 degree driver. So let's see how it goes. And right there is the other big benefit of this driver. The sound of the TS is much better than it was with 917 and even 915 as well. And one of those reasons is that the arc, which is the active recoil channel which they had in the previous driver, is not here anymore. Now, that's quite interesting because a lot of drivers do have effectively a slot, which is what that was trying to be. And that was there to help with the launch and help with the ball speed. But really the new design that they've got with the face and the way the weighting is gets the launch from having that CG further back, and you're getting the speed from the slightly faster head shape. So therefore you don't need the arc. And what that means is you can make it sound a little bit better as well, because generally these slots don't really help the sound. And now you're going back just to a more traditional, if you like, all titanium head that's hollow with not much going on inside. And that means they can really tailor the sound. And I think this is just a whole lot better than either previous models. So I have been here at the Bonny Banks of Loch Lomond. I was here today as part of a Titleist fitting session, just to understand the two models and see which one is best for me. So I won't go through the whole shebang of it, because it's very difficult for me to say to you that TS3 is better than TS2. You really have to go down and get with a professional Titleist fitter and go through the process, because actually it was a question of playing around with the heads, playing around with the lofts, and playing around with the shafts. And this is quite an interesting story, because it's not just about the heads. One of the things with Titleist drivers I felt was that they were always quite, maybe on the slightly heavier end of the scheme. And part of that was the head, and the other part of that was the shafts. They've actually gone for a lighter set of shafts, and there's a good range of shafts. There's a Mitsubishi Tenchi, there's an Even Flow, there's a Hazardous Smoke, and there's also this Kurikaji, which is the one I've got here and the one I ended up with. Now, these tend to be a lot lighter than have been in the past. And there's also, for the shafts that are under 60 grams in weight, what Titleist have done, it's called this straight flight weight, which is a tungsten weight, which is just positioned just where at the bottom of the grip on the inside of the shaft. And this is something that Titleist's own shaft people has said to Mitsubishi and the other shaft manufacturers, this is what we'd like in our club. And for those lighter weights, it actually helps with the stability of the club, and it helps turn the club over. And it actually was quite marked when I was hitting it, and maybe it was leaking to light. Once I had the shaft with the weight in it, it was straightening up, and it was actually a little bit uncanny, to be perfectly honest. But I have to say, I do like it. It's a little bit like counterbalancing weights, but within shafts as well. Now, the other thing you're going to notice is that as a stock option, these shafts are 45.5 inches long. And that, again, is a bit of a departure for Titleist. For years, they were telling us that 45 was the length used on tour, and that's the one you should have. And to be honest, I can still kind of go along with that, because the shorter shaft allows you a little bit more control, which means you're going to hit the middle of the club face a little bit more often, and you should get the distance because of a better impact, not because you've got a longer shaft that is swinging the club a little bit faster. For some people that will work, and with me and my Chapman sessions, it was actually easy. I could have taken either shaft. So then it was down to personal feel, and to me, I think I'm going to stick with the 45 inch shaft. So what I ended up with after all this fitting was, best club for me was TS2 in 9.5 degrees, which is 1 degree down from my 917, but we use adjustable hosel to change the setting to D4, which actually brings the loft back up again. So that was able to give me the extra ball speed from the straighter face, but a bit extra launch from the adjustable hosel to get the flight right and drop the spin. So going back to Trackman and comparing it to the 917, driver that I had, what I was getting was an extra 3 miles an hour on the 917, and then what I was translating into was an extra 8 yards of carry. So you can really see that there is a big gain to be had between 917 and TS, and I think from the evidence you're probably going to see for lots of people, they're all going to experience this. I will caveat by saying, obviously, Titleist already said that they felt the 917 could have been a wee bit faster, but really comparing this to other drivers in the market that I've been fitted for, this was right up with the fastest drivers in the market. The ball speed was the same. I'd say it was spinning a little bit less than some of the other high speed drivers, so it was probably low to mid spin for me in this setup compared to the other drivers which have been optimized. So therefore I was getting roughly about the same carry, a little bit more ball speed, a bit less spin, and therefore a bit more total distance, because I was able to run it out a little bit further. Overall then, I think Titleist have done a great job with the TS driver. I think if you're a Titleist loyalist and you stuck with it through 915 and 917, then I think you'll be well rewarded for this. I would definitely urge you to trade up if you like, because I think it definitely sounds a lot better, but more importantly, it's more forgiving, and it obviously goes a little bit further because you are getting that ball speed. I think everything that they're saying about it is definitely true. So really the test of the pudding is to take your own driver down, measure it up, go to a Titleist fitting center, and see which one of these two excellent drivers is going to be the best one for you. I hope that's provided you with enough information to make a good choice. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have, please feel free to drop some comments below. It'd be great to hear from you. Give us a thumbs up, and to keep in touch with us and get more of our videos, just subscribe to our YouTube channel. And then for more reviews on all Titleist golf equipment, just check out the golflot.com website.